Greetings, future Clippers. Welcome to our virtual open house. My name is Dr. Tamika Woodruff, and I am the Science and Technology Program Coordinator at Oxon Hill High School. At Oxon Hill, we truly understand the importance of choosing the best fit for your high school scholar. Hence, we hope that this presentation will answer some of your questions about the Science and Technology Program. If you have any unanswered questions at the conclusion of this presentation, please use the link shown on the slide or email me directly at oxonh.st@pgcps.org. The administration of Oxon Hill is led by our awesome principal, Ms. Marcy Holland. We also have Mr. Ryan Nowitzki, grade 12, Ms. Naima Vinson, grade 11, Ms. Patricia Duffy, grade 10, and Dr. Portia Barnes, grade 9. Dr. Barnes is also the Science and Tech Program Administrator. So, Principal Holland has a welcome message for you. Let's hear it.
Hello, Clippers, and congratulations on your acceptance into our Oxon Hill High School's Science and Technology Program. My name is Ms. Holland, and I am very proud to serve as your principal. Unfortunately, due to safety reasons, I am unable to meet you in person, but look forward to meeting with you soon. Within this presentation, you will receive information from our phenomenal science and technology coordinator, Dr. Woodruff, some of our excellent teachers, and some of our amazing science and technology students. Some of the information that you will hear about will be in regards to registration, course offerings, and electives. You will also receive information about our athletic program from our phenomenal athletic director, Ms. Greenfield. It is our mission for the students that are in our science and technology program to receive adequate access to science, technology, engineering, and math. These are critical elements to ensure that students are successful in colleges, careers, and within life. So congratulations again, class of 2024. Welcome aboard, and I look forward to our journey together.
At Oxon Hill High School, we have a diverse student population. This year, our eligible and waitlisted students come from over 40 different locations, which is shown on your screen. We congratulate all of you on this accomplishment. Again, my name is Dr. Tamika Woodruff, and I will be helping you to navigate our virtual open house. I am the Science and Technology Program Coordinator at Oxon Hill High School. In this presentation, we will cover the following agenda items. We will review Oxon Hill High School, as well as the Prince George's County Public Schools Science and Technology Program. In addition, we will review the registration process, and lastly, we will share some teacher and student perspectives about the Science and Technology Program at Oxon Hill High School. I'd like to start by telling you a little bit about Oxon Hill. Oxon Hill is a high school located in the southern region of Prince George's County with a student population of 1,478 students. Of those, 563 students are in the Science and Technology program. Our mission is to provide a quality education that develops the content knowledge, skills, and attitudes that will enable all students to reach their maximum potential as responsible, lifelong learners, and productive citizens. The rigorous academic program at Oxon Hill High School boasts 18 advanced placement courses, 19 advanced STEM elective courses, as well as 3 dual enrollment opportunities right on our campus. Dual enrollment is a program that enables students to earn college credits while still in high school by taking courses at local colleges and universities for credit. In addition to dual enrollment, our students have an opportunity to participate in over 30 clubs and organizations, as well as 11 national honor societies. At Oxon Hill High School, we strive to provide our scholars with opportunities to learn and be supported through a number of rigorous educational opportunities. We have a saying here at Oxon Hill, once a Clipper, always a Clipper. Many of our science and technology program scholars are well-rounded and participate and lead many of the clubs and organizations at Oxon Hill High School. In addition, we have a great deal of student athletes. Here, we will listen to a message from Ms. Cecile Greenfield, the Oxon Hill High School Athletic Director. Ms. Greenfield will discuss the Clipper Athletics Program and how to become a Clipper athlete. There will also be additional videos from other Clipper staff later in this presentation.
Hey everyone, Ms. Greenfield here. I am the athletic director from Oxon Hill High School. I'm here to talk to you today about athletics at Oxon Hill High School. We offer three seasons, fall, winter, and spring. In the fall, we offer volleyball, golf, fall cheer, football, soccer, and cross country. In the winter, we offer basketball, wrestling, indoor track, swim, winter cheer. In the spring, we offer baseball, softball, lacrosse, tennis, and outdoor track. If you are interested in finding out more information about individual sports, I suggest you go to our website here. And you can follow us on Twitter at OHHS Athletics or Instagram at Clippers Athletics. Thank you for watching. Once a Clipper.
So what is science and tech? The Science and Technology Program is a four-year comprehensive program that focuses on building students' knowledge and skills in STEM. Oxon Hill services scholars from the southern region of Prince George's County. As I previously mentioned, Science and Technology Program students also have access to a rigorous education through advanced placement, advanced STEM, and dual enrollment courses. Further, students engage in meaningful coursework related to the STEM majors that they select at the end of their freshman year. Our Science and Technology Program students also graduate from our program college and career ready, as evidenced by our 100% college acceptance rate. Here, we will listen to a brief message from Ms. Carolyn Famtran, who is a Science and Technology Program senior. She will share her perspective on science and tech and her internship experience. Internship is an opportunity for science and tech seniors to engage in experiential learning and mentorship from experts in STEM fields while still in high school. Our students intern at many locations, such as USDA, NASA, and Andrews Air Force Base.
Hi everyone, my name is Carolyn Famtran. I'm a senior here at Oxon Hill High School, and I'm currently doing the biology major right now. My experience here at Oxon Hill High School has been very, very fruitful. I have worked very hard to get to where I am, and I would say the hard work has definitely paid off. These 4 years have been fun. I have been surrounded by a culture of students that are very driven, which in turn inspired me to be driven about my future. I have been given a lot of opportunities to actually explore STEM fields, and I still have a life outside of science and tech as well, being able to participate in National Honor Society, lacrosse, GSA, SGA, and etc. I'm currently the National Honor Society president, and I still take part of Varsity's Girls Lacrosse. So for those who are wondering if their child or if you can have a life while still maintaining the rigorous schedule of science and tech, yes, yes you can, if you try. all the faculty support science and tech very well. They're very helpful. My internship at Children's Hospital, I would have to shout out Dr. Woodruff because she really helped me out and she helped connecting me to that. And they will always give you opportunities here to thrive. And I think that's what really enriched my experience here as well. These 4 years has been a lot, but I think with RP and doing your whole research practicum project, it really builds you into a better student. And I'm not gonna lie, it will be a little bit hard, but being able to pick up that workload helps mold you into a better student, a better scholar in general. And I believe that if you choose this program, I think you're on a great track. All right, bye guys.
There are many benefits of choosing the Science and Technology program at Oxon Hill High School for your child's educational journey. Our students have an opportunity to learn in an environment with like-minded scholars. In addition, the program provides scholars with exposure to STEM contents and STEM career fields through providing guest speakers, allowing students to go on college or STEM field trips. In addition, our seniors have an opportunity to get that in-depth exposure to a STEM career through an internship experience wherein they work alongside a STEM professional to complete a year-long research study in their research practicum course. As previously stated, students can also, you know, advance academically beyond the high school level by taking those college-level courses through the dual enrollment program. This program enables students to begin taking their college-level courses the summer following their 10th grade year. STEM internships are definitely one of the major highlights of the Science and Technology program. Mrs. King Davis is the internship coordinator at Oxon Hill High School. She and I work with our partners and students to place them into meaningful internships during their senior year. Here is a brief video of Mrs. King Davis explaining the Oxon Hill High School internship program.
Good day. My name is Mrs. King Davis, and I am currently serving as the internship coordinator at Oxon Hill High School for the Science and Technology program. Internship has amazing opportunities. One of the most amazing opportunities for internship is being able to learn outside of the four walls. Another thing is most of our students are offered summer jobs after they intern, and in some cases, careers. We currently have internships at over 20 sites, and we are constantly growing. A few of our sites include Children's Hospital, USDA, NASA, Howard University, University of Maryland, and a host of others. We also have small partnerships such as Cultivate the City, as well as small private-owned practices that doctors allow our students to come and partake in an internship there. This is an amazing opportunity. So if you have the chance in your senior year, I hope to see you. And remember, once a Clipper, always a Clipper.
A student in the Science and Technology program must meet the Maryland State Department of Education requirements for graduation, along with the Science and Technology program's requirements to graduate from Prince George's County Public Schools with the Science and Tech endorsement on your high school transcript. There are three primary standards for science and tech students. These include attendance, academics, and behavior. All of the items shown on your screen fall into one of these three primary categories. The specific requirements include upholding the PGCPS Student Code of Conduct, maintaining a minimum grade point average of a 2.5, receiving a grade no lower than a C in any STEM course, meeting the course requirements for one of the four STEM majors, completing a science fair project each year, advancing to at least pre-calculus and mathematics, passing an approved advanced placement STEM course, and completing one of the four pathways to prove college and career readiness through the Science and Technology program. This slide shows a sample planner for the average science and technology program student. I do not plan to go over this slide in depth today, but there are a few things that I would like to point out. First, there are three primary science and tech majors, which include biological science, computer science, and engineering. However, we do have a fourth major for undecided students, which is called exploratory. Under each of the majors listed on your screen, you can see our advanced STEM elective courses for that major. But the focus of ninth grade year is for students to begin to complete the Maryland State Department of Education graduation requirements. Hence, scholars are expected to complete their health and PE requirements as well as their fine arts requirements in the ninth grade. Students will actually take their first advanced STEM courses beginning in the 10th grade. Science and technology program students are also required to take AP or honors courses in science, social studies, and English. Let's hear from our ninth grade honors English teacher, Mrs. Michelle Phillips.
Hi, I'm Mrs. Michelle Phillips, and I teach the first year science and tech program students in the English department, as well as 11th grade AP language and composition. Our program of studying in the English department for the science and tech program is pretty rigorous. We deal with building skills such as critical and analytical skills, collaborative conversation, oral presentation, interpersonal, as well as intercultural skills. Our goal is to build a community of well-rounded young leaders who are able to effectively communicate and appreciate the power of ideas in science and able to effectively communicate the power of technology in a world that is constantly changing. I have provided links on the next slide to give you kind of insight into my classroom, to the lessons, to the technology, and to some of the work that the students do in my classroom. I look forward to working with you next year in the Science and Tech program.
To help you learn more about Oxon Hill High School student life, next we'll hear from a Science and Technology program sophomore, Ms. Trinity Cephas, who's taken her first Science and Technology program course this year.
Hi everyone, my name is Trinity Cephas, and a little bit about me for starters is I'm a sophomore, you already know, class of 2022. Now, I'm also a student athlete. Now, what that means is I can manage sports and my academics. Now, I did volleyball in the fall. I ran indoor track during the winter, and hopefully I can do outdoor track if everything goes back to settle. Now, as a sophomore, you are given the option to choose a science and tech elective through your major. Now, my major is biology. So the science and tech elective I chose was microbiology/anatomy and physiology. I took microbiology first semester, and I took anatomy and physiology right now. I love it, highly recommend it. Also, as a sophomore, you can choose an AP course, and that AP course is AP government. I highly recommend it, but the one thing about an AP course is you have to manage your time in terms of you have to get all this work done on top of other classes. So if you're good at managing your time and you're really good, you have to stay on your due dates. Because this AP course, you have to turn in stuff on time. Highly recommend it. It's worth it. And it boosts your GPA. So, anyway, bye!
Registering your child to attend the Science and Technology program at Oxon Hill High School requires some planning on your part. Please use the listing on this slide as well as the listing sent to your emails as a guide. Only a parent or court-appointed guardian may register a student in Prince George's County Public Schools. If a student is residing with anyone else, they must either obtain legal court-appointed guardianship or apply for kinship care approval. Please secure originals and make copies of documents that you will have to provide to the registrar at the time of your registration. The registrar does not accept online printouts at this time. In addition, official marriage and/or name change certificates are required if the parent or guardian's last name differs from the name on your scholar's birth certificate. Families who share housing will need the appropriate shared housing document signed and notarized by both parties and must include a copy of the proof of ownership or lease of the person granting shared housing, as well as two items from the approved supporting residential documentation that is addressed to the parent or guardian. For additional information, please visit the PGCPS website on registration at www.pgcps.org/registration. If a parent or court-appointed guardian is living with a friend or relative as their principal residence, a notarized shared housing disclosure form signed by both parties detailing the living arrangement is required. The following conditions must be met. All parties must sign the notarized shared housing disclosure. The relative or friend with whom the parents reside must show their proof of residence. The parent registering the child must present official mail to the school within 30 days of enrollment. The required mail items may consist of original items, including a statement from an employer showing the new address, bank statements, car registration, car insurance policy, government or official correspondence. The parent should be advised that the school system reserves the right to monitor this type of proof periodically or as needed. The shared housing agreement also must be renewed annually. In addition to the items shown on the previous slide, the items shown on this slide are also required at the time of registration. Again, please be certain to bring both originals and copies of all necessary forms. Due to the school closure because of the coronavirus pandemic, we will have to reschedule our registration dates. Please help us to get you in and out for registration in as timely a process as possible by having all of this documentation ready and following the next steps that I will provide to you via email. Registration dates will not be adjusted until school resumes. At Oxon Hill High School, our parents are truly our partners. The next two slides will be videos from some of our parent partners. The first slide is from PTSA President and Science and Tech Parent, Dr. Tamara Johnson, and the next slide will be Mrs. Konahia, a senior parent.
Hello, my name is Dr. Tamara Johnson, and I'm the current PTSA president of the award-winning Oxon Hill High School. We've partnered with Principal Holland, parents, teachers, students, staff, and administration to not only represent the school, but also to represent and take care of our scholars. We have approximately 180 members with six community partners. We look forward to meeting you and your family next year. If you have any questions or concerns, please feel free to contact me at ptsa.ohhs.president@gmail.com. Thank you.
Now we will hear from Mrs. Konahia.
Congratulations on being accepted into Oxon Hill High School Science and Technology program. My name is Diana Konohia, and I'm the parent of a senior at Oxon Hill. One of the things that I really appreciated about Matthew's time at Oxon Hill was the support that he received. So much so that Matthew felt very confident in his ability to advocate for himself because of the love that he felt and the care and concern that he felt from Dr. Woodruff and Ms. King Davis and the other staff members of the Science and Technology Department. The other thing was the clarity of direction that I also appreciated. He went in thinking he wanted to pursue one type of engineering, but because of all he was exposed to, he decided to pursue a different type of engineering. And as a parent, that's what you really want your child's high school experience to be. I look forward to meeting you, and I hope to see you in a future event. Welcome to Oxon Hill.
Transportation is definitely provided to the Zoned Science and Technology Program Center for all students who are accepted and registered into our program. Please note that this transportation is based upon the address that is in SchoolMax. At Oxon Hill High School, we do work really hard to ensure that our scholars are college and career ready. While we do have a group of students who choose to go into the military post high school, the vast majority of our scholars attend college. In 2019, our students were accepted into approximately 200 schools and were offered over 24 million in scholarships, and that is just for the students in the science and technology program. Oxon Hill High School received over 28 million in scholarship offers as a whole. The Oxon Hill High School current senior class has received over $13 million in scholarship offers, and we have plenty of collection time left. I would like to take a moment to really summarize this slide. In the email with your presentation, you also received a PDF document that contains the pages on this slide. To the left, you will notice a flowchart, and after making your decision, please use this flowchart for guidance. So if your child is eligible and you accept the seat, please use the link in the parent welcome email to review the registration information, complete the summer bridge and course selection Google Forms, and complete registration on your assigned date whenever it's provided. And we look forward to working with you and your scholar over the next 4 years. However, if your child is eligible and you've decided on another program and or you would like to decline your child's seat, please update the intent Google form. This enables us to move through the waiting list as efficiently as possible. In addition, it will keep you from receiving additional calls and emails regarding your child's decision. If your child's on the wait list and you would like to accept your child's seat, please wait for a call from the coordinator prior to coming to register. Due to the closing of PGCPS until April 24th, again, the registration dates must be adjusted. As you wait on the next steps, everyone can do the following. Double check and make certain to gather all of your required documents. Make copies of these documents as both originals and copies are required. Complete the summer bridge and the course selection form and discuss elective options with your scholar. All accepted and registered students are expected to participate in the First Steps to Success Summer Bridge program. This Summer Bridge program provides our new Clippers with exposure to Oxon Hill High School as well as the Science and Technology program. Summer Bridge has three primary components, including building academic capacity, helping with the social transition to high school, and allowing the students to have fun through team building. In Summer Bridge, our scholars begin to build relationships with their classmates and teachers at Oxon Hill High School who will help them through their secondary career. Please note that transportation is not provided for our Summer Bridge program, and as of this time, there have been no changes to the Summer Bridge schedule. Now, we will hear from Milan Jefferson, who is a science and tech freshman who went through the Summer Bridge program last year.
My name is Milan Jefferson, and I am a rising ninth grader at Oxon Hill High School. Transitioning from middle school to high school is not an easy task, but as long as you know what to do, it's easier than you expect. One of the things that helped me prepare for high school was the Summer Bridge Program. During the Summer Bridge Program, I got to meet new people that I would spend the rest of high school with. I got to meet some staff and teachers, and I got to learn more about the school. One of my favorite things to do at the program was the scavenger hunt. At the scavenger hunt, we broke into groups and we all challenged to find different clues around the school to win a prize. And that allowed you to understand the school better and get a sense for when you came instead of scrambling around not knowing where to go. One of my tips for transitioning from middle school to high school would to be just get in the habit of studying. Studying is something that you really need in order to excel in classes. I never studied in middle school, but as soon as I got that one teacher that I needed to study for, I started studying for all my classes, and classes were a breeze. So my name is Melissa Jefferson, and those are some things you need to know about transitioning.
Students who are on the wait list are called as seats are declined by eligible students. Please make sure that the information you provided on the intent Google form is correct. Once you are called from the waiting list, you will have 24 hours to respond to accept the seat. It is imperative that you are checking your emails and voicemails consistently during this time to ensure that you do not miss any contact from the program coordinator. Please note that Oxon Hill High School does not have the wait list and requests students off the wait list until all slots are filled. Remember, if you have any questions, please use the link provided in your email to submit your questions or email me directly at oxonh.st@pgcps.org. In addition, gather all of your registration documents and make copies. And don't forget to check your emails regularly for any updates on registration. At Oxon Hill High School, we have a saying, the Clipper Way. Well, I made a short video to show Oxon Hill High School and the Clipper Way. I hope you enjoy it.
So everybody in the room, I'm guessing, with Boston College, right?
Yes.
Yeah, great.
Thank you.
This is the conclusion of the narrated portion of our virtual open house. However, there are additional slides containing videos of staff and students from Oxon Hill High School who have additional perspectives and or programs to share with you that may help you in making your decision. As I bring our virtual open house to a close, I want to thank each and every one of you for taking the time to view our virtual open house presentation. I hope that the information and knowledge that you have gained throughout this presentation will assist you in making an informed decision with regards to your scholar's secondary career. We really, really hope that you will join us and consider the Oxon Hill High School Clipper family. As we say at Oxon Hill, once a Clipper, always a Clipper.
Welcome, class of 2024. So we have four counselors in the school counseling department. Class of 2021 is Ms. Smalls Gregory. Class of 2022 is Ms. Jones. Class of 2023 is Ms. Jameson. And class of 2024, which is your class, is myself, Ms. Melton. So some fun facts about me. I graduated from Oxon Hill High School in 2008. So that once a Clipper, always a Clipper that you will hear once you come to Oxon Hill is very true and dear to my heart because I am a Clipper and I always will be. I've worked at Oxon Hill High School for 4 years. This year, I am currently the senior counselor, which is why I roll over to you guys next year. My favorite thing to do is travel. I'm very passionate about working with my students, and I cannot wait to meet you guys. The goals of the school counselor department and counselors are to help the students transition from middle to high school, of course. We work with you with social emotional issues, academic support, of course, creating your schedule changes. Certifying graduates is our biggest role in explaining graduation requirements to you all and making sure you understand what you need to graduate. The biggest thing I want to explain to you guys would be scheduling. So these are a few notes that you would need to know for scheduling next year. So ninth grade students are usually taking all graduation requirements during their freshman year, unless you have met certain requirements in middle school. And those requirements are usually foreign languages, maybe your Algebra 1 geometry or Algebra 2 or biology. Nothing outside of that really comes from middle school. And your foreign language cannot be intro. It has to be level 1, 2, or 3. You will have 8 classes a year. We work on an A day, B day schedule, so that's 4 classes a day. And ROTC for my science and tech students, if you are interested in being in ROTC for 4 years, that is not a graduation required course. And as I stated before, ninth grade, you are usually taking all 8 graduation requirement classes. So if you want to take ROTC, you will have to eliminate one of those classes, which will usually be your fine art or your foreign language. If you finished your foreign language in middle school, you're good to go. You have space for your ROTC. If you do not, you will start ROTC or your fine art in 10th or 11th grade. So next year, your schedule will look like the following, unless, of course, you opt to be in ROTC or you finished your foreign language. You have to have 2 years. So that's example, Spanish 1, Spanish 2, French 1, French 2. You cannot take Spanish 1 and French 1 and then meet those graduation requirements. It has to be the same foreign language coming from middle school. In high school, you can take 2 different ones to earn that graduation requirement. Back to your schedule for next year. So for science and tech students, you will have English 9 honors, Algebra 1. If you took Algebra 1 and passed it in middle school, you will be in geometry. If you took Algebra 1 and geometry in middle school, you will be in Algebra 2. If you took all 3, of course, you would go straight into trigonometry or you could take pre-calculus. You will have U.S. History Honors, Biology, Science, and Tech. For those students that have taken biology and passed it in eighth grade, you will take Chemistry, Science, and Tech. Foundations of Tech, ST, is your tech education credit for graduation. Personal fitness and health issues, of course, those are graduation requirements as well. And you need one fine art credit to graduate. So those are a list of different options you can take for that. And then, of course, your foreign language. And those are the four options that we offer. Every single one of those classes that I listed is graduation requirements. Email me if you have any questions. Thank you.
Greetings, future Clippers. My name is Amber Heller, and I am the Advanced Placement Program Coordinator at Oxon Hill High School. I've created this short video to provide you with a little bit of information about advanced placement, what the program is, how you as a scholar can benefit, and then also about the wide variety of advanced placement courses that we have available at Oxon Hill. So first off, what is advanced placement? I'm sure by now all of you are familiar with College Board. Okay, College Board is a company that offers standardized college level courses for high school students in addition to all of those entrance exams like the SAT. You all are probably familiar with the PSAT 8-9 that was used as an entrance to advanced programs in Prince George's County Public Schools. Okay, so College Board sponsors a wide variety of programs from entrance exams to college prep, and advanced placement is just another one of those programs. Okay, so essentially, students take college level courses in high school, and the curriculum is sponsored by College Board and approved by College Board. And at the end of the course, students who receive qualifying scores on the end of course exam may be granted college credit depending on the university that they are attending. Okay, so that's a little bit about advanced placement. Again, it's college level courses for possible college credit in high school. So why take an AP course? I've got three great reasons. Number one, it's a challenge. AP courses involve a great deal more rigor. The courses go beyond just, you know, memorizing facts for a state curriculum. They involve higher order thinking, problem solving, project-based learning, and are really designed to evolve your thinking and not just have you, you know, retain a bunch of information. So that's number one. Number two, building better habits. You will feel more confident in going to college and taking college level courses having had this experience. And finally, colleges view you as being better prepared to take on the challenges of college if they feel you've already been exposed to college level work in high school. Okay, and then of course, this trims the cost of college. If you are better ready to take your college courses and have a higher rate of success and entering college with credit, all of this helps to you know, alleviate the cost of going to a four-year university. At Oxon Hill High School, we do have certain expectations that we want you to be aware of. Students do sign a contract prior to registration in our AP courses. Most important, I wanted to highlight that the end of course exams are optional for a fee. We do uphold very strict academic integrity standards, and all students who are taking AP courses are expected to complete summer assignments. Finally, I just wanted to open up to show you the wide variety of advanced placement courses that we do offer at Oxon Hill High School. We do have a couple of courses offered online, but other than that, we have courses in all areas from foreign language, social studies, English science, computer science, and art. And I fully expect that I will see all of you in advanced placement courses. I hope that this presentation was helpful in your decision to come to Oxon Hill High School and be a thriving member of our advanced placement program. If you have any questions, please feel free to email me, amber.heller@pgcps.org.
Hi, I'm Lieutenant Colonel Branch, Senior Aerospace Science Instructor at Oxon Hill High School. I'm going to give you a little bit of information about Junior ROTC at Oxon Hill. What do? We build better citizens for America. That's the motto of Air Force Junior ROTC. How do we do it? We provide guidance. As instructors, we provide guidance and boundaries to the cadets because the cadets lead or organize the program itself. It's a cadet-led program, unlike many others. We provide the guidance to the cadets. They'll come to us for advice. If we see something that can be improved, we'll give the advice freely to make sure that things are done properly. Some of the organizations within Air Force Junior ROTC, we have an Academic Honor Society, which is the Kitty Hawk Air Society. We have a color guard. They present colors at local events and in the school. We have a drill team. They compete and they do performances in the community and in the school and in competitions. We have a Cyber Patriot team. They compete in nationwide cyber defense competitions. One of the mainstays of Air Force Junior ROTC is community service. So far this year, we've completed 22 community service projects, and about a dozen cadets have completed more than 22 community service hours. One requirement of Air Force Junior ROTC is uniform wear. All cadets must wear their uniform once a week on their designated day, which would be either a Wednesday or a Thursday. They would wear the uniform all day to school and would be graded on that. In order to get a uniform, they also must come close to the grooming standards for the Air Force for uniform wear. There is a hair bulk and length. There are fingernail requirements, there are facial hair requirements. So if your child is not willing to comply with any of these requirements, Air Force Junior ROTC is not for them. Requirements aren't that strict. We have more than 250 cadets who do them, but they are requirements. So hopefully you'll consider Air Force Junior ROTC and its leadership potential and its leadership experience for your student. Thank you.
Thank you. name is Crystal Ferguson, and on behalf of the Art Department Chair, Ms. Rico, I'm happy to introduce the amazing art programs we offer our students at Oxon Hill High School. Our art electives include Art 1 and Digital Photography. For students considering AP Studio Design, you must enroll in and successfully complete Art 2 in the 10th grade. And by recommendation only, will you be able to enroll in AP Studio 2 Dimensional Design and or AP Studio Drawing. For students interested in digital art, we are glad to offer a digital photography elective. Digital photography will help students understand the digital camera, shooting techniques, and introduce students to the industry standard photo manipulation software tools, Adobe Photoshop and Adobe Lightroom. Digital photography is designed to explore the possibility of creating new narratives and new art in the ever-expanding medium, digital devices. This course takes place in the Interactive Media CTE Mac Lab. Interactive Media CTE students use design thinking methodology to discover creative ways to communicate through visual design and engage audiences in interactive media. Again, we're excited about you coming aboard the Clipper ship, and we're always excited about art. We hope that you enroll in one of our art classes and look forward to meeting you when you do.
Hello everyone, my name is Daniel Mid. I am currently a science and tech student at Oxon Hill High School under the science and technology field. I'm an exploratory major. This year I take around three AP classes, which include AP Chemistry, AP World History, and AP Language and Composition. AP classes are beneficial whether it be to boost your GPA or to earn college credits. Taking three AP classes can be a bit challenging with the right amount of time management, and being organized can really help make things a lot easier. Dual enrollment is also an option for science and tech students to take. Many times students take it either after school or before. For students who are juniors, it's recommended to take it after school, since dual enrollment classes does help earn also college credit, because most of the classes you'll be offered if you pass the EcuPacer or general classes, which almost all associate's degree require. And lastly, I would recommend taking electives or advanced electives for science and tech, because a lot of times you might be able to get a glimpse of other subjects and other categories to learn about, and it might be beneficial for you in your future for choosing colleges or even careers and finding things that you're interested in. And that is my take of being an 11th grader.
Hey guys, hope everyone is doing well. My name is Zora. I'm a current senior here at Oxon Hill High School, a part of the Science and Technology program. So I'm basically going to talk to you about two different parts. First, my internship process, and then second, my overall experience of Oxon Hill High School. So currently, I'm interning at Joint Base Andrews, and I'm partnering with the Public Affairs Squadron, which deals with media and things of that nature. And my goal and my project with them was to create a website. In which we try and get people of the civilian world and both military and civilian world to come into the newly Spark Excel Innovation Center. And in that center, we they have features, they have access to 3D printing, coding, virtual reality, and so many different things. And we basically want to bring in these different groups to just show them that we have these different resources that you are free to use. It's free of charge. And with the website, we tapped in, you know, classes that they can register for, you know, questions that they may not, they want answers to, but they don't feel like going on base, if you get what I'm saying. So that's what the website was for, is basically to reach out to those people who don't really know about it and who don't necessarily have to come to the base, who want to get more information about that. I will say that the connections that I made with the individuals, the ladies and gentlemen at Spark Excel Innovation Center, really helped me in terms of college. So I will be going to Virginia Tech University with a major in microbiology, but I'm going in as an ROTC student. So currently I'm a junior ROTC student, so wanting to pursue a military career was something that, you know, was already in my mind. But the connections that I made at Spark Excel really helped me to get in touch with, you know, commanders at Virginia Tech and helping me get into, like, you know, the process of registering as a cadet at Virginia Tech. So I will say that the interactions and the connections that you make with your internship and your mentors is really, really beneficial, not only to your high school career, but to your post-high school and collegiate career as well. So, my overall experience of Oxon High School. I came to the school ninth grade. I've been here all 4 years. And originally it was, you know, I struggled with making friends, but I will say that, you know, there's always something going on in Oxon Hill. And through that, I mean, extracurricular, sports, there's always something going on. So I was really able to, like, you know, make my friends, things like that, through extracurricular activities. And thus, you know, my experience since then has been amazing. And, you know, I have a 3.8. I really wish it was better, but, you know, in that, I've joined a whole bunch of, organizations we have here at Oxon Hill High School. I've, you know, exceeded beyond, like, I've totally exceeded the amount of community service hours that I have. So in terms of the experience overall, I don't have any complaints. Yeah, that's it for me. I hope you guys enjoy the rest of the presentation. I can't say I look forward to seeing you next year because I won't be here, but good luck in the rest of your high school search.
Hello, everybody. My name is Elijah Mosley. I'm currently a science and technology senior at Oxon Hill High School, and I'm currently in the dual enrollment program, and I'm also the president of the instrumental music department's band. With my personal experience being a part of the science and technology program, is that it gave me the opportunity to feel comfortable and grow in the school. When I was a freshman, you know, I was coming into this huge brand new building, I was nervous and I was unsure of, you know, what to expect. But by being in the science and technology program and the instrumental music department, I was constantly being prepared for college and career readiness, as well as building confidence and feeling like I belong at Oxon Hill. Right now, I mentioned earlier that I'm in the dual enrollment program. And I've had the opportunity to take college courses at Prince George's Community College and earn credits on my college transcript. Now, these credits can be, once you earn these credits can be transferred to whatever university that you would like to attend, depending on what the university accepts on that transcript. But also by being in this program, you have the chance, by being in the dual enrollment program, I've had the chance to take actual college courses alongside with college students and learn from the actual professor. One of the reasons why this program is really nice is because it eases the transition from a high school classroom to a college classroom, and it helps the students feel comfortable. It helps the students at Oxon Hill feel comfortable with classmates of different age groups and settings. Now, being in the science tech program, it will be challenging, yes, throughout all 4 years of high school. But in the end, it really does pay off and it does prepare you for your next steps in education. For anyone interested, down below is a link to a full presentation on what the purpose of the instrumental music department is and what it offers. So if anybody is interested in becoming a musician and learning a new instrument, or if you already are a musician and you just want to continue your musical literacy and all that, then by all means click on the link. And yeah, thank you.